Hey there, thanks for tuning in today. I'm Dr. Morgan Nolte. I wanted to let you know that the video you're watching is a clip of a longer episode that's very in-depth about the best foods to eat to lower blood sugar. So if you're interested in learning more about that, I'll link the full video below in the description. Please be sure to subscribe to this channel, give the video a thumbs up, leave a comment, and share it with a friend if you find it helpful. Thanks for watching and enjoy this clip. Takeaway number four is to avoid sugar-free ingredients that still raise blood sugar. Now, while macronutrients are important, they don't tell the full story. A food may have zero carbs, heck, it could have zero calories and still impact blood sugar. This is where it becomes important to screen packaged foods for a few key ingredients to avoid. Here are the main artificial sweeteners and texture additives to look out for on the ingredients list. Maltodextrin, sucralose, saccharin, aspartame, and acesulfame potassium. If it has these, steer clear because chances are this sugar-free product will still raise your blood sugar. The first ingredient is maltodextrin. Maltodextrin is a white powder made from corn, rice, potato starch, or wheat. Even though it comes from plants, it's highly processed. I did a little research into maltodextrin and was a little grossed out by what I found. Maltodextrin is used as a thickener or filler to increase the volume of a processed food. It's also used as a thickener in personal care items, such as lotion and hair care products. So if eating lotion or hair care products sounds good to you, go ahead and eat that maltodextrin. It's also a preservative that increases the shelf life of packaged foods. It's inexpensive and easy to produce, so it's useful for thickening products such as instant pudding and gelatins, sauces, and salad dressings. Here are a few examples I found in my parents' pantry, even though I talked with them about this before. That's how I knew I needed to do a video on it. Sugar-free Jell-O, sugar-free jam, Crystal Light, and many other similar pouches that you add to water. It can also be combined with artificial sweeteners to sweeten products such as canned fruits, desserts, and again, those powdered drinks. Maltodextrin has an even higher glycemic index than table sugar. This means that maltodextrin can cause a sharp increase or spike in your blood sugar shortly after you eat foods that contain it. The other sugar-free ingredients I want you to look out for are the artificial sweetener saccharin, also called sweetened low, sucralose, aka Splenda, aspartame, aka NutraSweet and Equal, and acesulfame potassium, aka ACE-K and Sunnet. All of these have been found to raise blood sugar levels by dramatically changing the makeup of your gut bacteria. These are also known as post-oral metabolic effects. Unlike maltodextrin, they may not immediately impact your blood glucose, but over time they will contribute to insulin resistance and poor blood sugar control. If you're trying to reduce your sugar intake but still want a healthy sweetener, I recommend sticking to stevia, monk fruit, or erythritol. Stevia and monk fruit tend to be a little easier on the gut and cause less gas than erythritol. So instead of having this no sugar added hot cocoa that has maltodextrin, acesulfame potassium, and sucralose, you could just make your own with some milk, cocoa powder, and stevia drops. That's what we do in our house, and my kids love it. Again, it's these simple, easy, delicious swaps that will make your healthy lifestyle stick.